Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to another video on Jetpack Compose. In the previous video, we saw how to work with colors and how to apply the colors to the various UI components like composables. And we also understood how to use the theme to get the consistent look and feel. In this video, we will look at the last concept of theming basics, that is shapes. Well, in Android UI, you will see various components like buttons, surfaces, cards, and any custom components that you might build. Usually, these have default shapes, and you may want to actually fiddle with these things and change the shapes. And this video is all about how to do that. So before we get into the actual demo, let's try to understand what are the some of the default shapes that are supported in Android and what else we need to be aware of before we get into this part. So broadly speaking, there are four types of shapes here, that is rectangle, circle, rounded corner and cut corner. And then there are around five different types of sizes that we are dealing with. Basically, extra small, small, medium, large, and extra large. If you don't understand it right now, just park it for a few moments. Now, what you usually do is, you create your own file called as shape.kt, and here you set the different sizes, that is extra small, small, medium, large, and extra large. And then you give the reference to this particular shape.kt in your theme.kt, and you create shapes equal to reply shapes, which is basically the variable that you had created in shape.kt. And in this way, you will get a very consistent shapes applied to your application. So let's get into a demo and see how this actually works. So this is my application, and this is how it looks like as of now. In the last video, we basically applied the color to the background and the card, and even applied the color to the border. Now, what we will do is we will try to change the shape. Well, you have this country card, and one of the another attribute that you can use is called as shape. There are various options that are available. There is rounded corner shape, there is rectangle shape, there is circle shape, and even cut corner shape. So let's go with as simple as rounded corner shape, and you want to tell how much rounding off of the corner should happen. So there are various options. You can give it in dp, float, percent, and if you want to change the amount of rounding off at the corner depending upon whether it is top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right, you can do that as well. There is a top start, top end, bottom end, and bottom start. Instead of doing that, I will use the most simple one, which is this percent, and I will say 10, which is an integer, so it is 10% rounding off. And now if I just run this, this is the rounding off you are getting in the card. And if you're not interested in giving it in percentages, you can also give it in dps, that is dot dp, and this will make it in terms of density independent pixel. And other than this, there is an option like cut corner shape. Cut corner shape is, instead of a curve, you will get a straight cut. So something like this 10 dp, it will basically cut the corners of the shape with 10 dp. And if you just give circle shape and just run it, just for the sake of checking, this is how it will look. Doesn't look good. So let me just change it and make it say rounded corner shape and percentage say 5%. That's it. Let's assume that you want to apply this particular shape without having to explicitly give this like this. Okay, so let me just go here. Under this UI theme, I will create a Kotlin file called as shape.kt, and here value custom shapes equal to shapes extra large, and for the extra large I mean, it's up to you. You want to go from extra large to extra small or extra small to extra large. So in this case, I will write extra large rounded corner shape. Let me make it say 30 dp. And in the same way, I will define other values. Extra large, large, medium, small, and extra small. And I can keep decreasing this. Say maybe 25, 20, 10, 5. And now I can use this custom shape in the themes.kt and define the shapes.kt here in the material theme. Now, when you do this, if you go to the country cards, instead of using rounded corner shape here, 5, you can just remove this and run it. Right now, by default, it is getting the rectangle. Instead of that, what you can do is material theme dot shapes dot medium. And now if you use this and run it, you will get a rounded corner shape. Material medium looks too big. You can make it actually small. And now if I run this, yeah, this looks much better. And let's assume that you want to change this rounded corner shape in case of medium. So instead of rounded shape, you want to use cut corner shape and maybe cut corner shape with 10 dB. And then if you use that here, then you will get the cut corner shape. And once again, you are getting the cut corner shape everywhere. Once again, you don't want that. You can come here, cut corner shape, bottom end percent 10. Yeah, this looks slightly better. So this is how you basically change the shapes of the composables in Jetpack Compose. So with this, we have basically completed everything that we need to cover as a part of the composable theming basics. In the next video, we will move on to another new topic as a part of Jetpack Compose. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.